Hey, what is up guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video we got the gameplay and review of Rex in Disney Mirrorverse. So if you are new, please leave a like and subscribe for more videos on the channel, and also follow my ex in the description down below to stay updated when I do upload new videos on the channel. So before the video starts, I gotta give a quick disclaimer. I am part of the KCP, the Krabam Creator Program, where I get to test out these guardians every single month. They get added to my account and I get to test it out in older content. I can't do new content of these guardians, and basically after a certain amount of time these guardians get removed from my account, so I do not benefit from having them. So let's get straight into it. We're going to go over his core ability first. Obviously we know that Rex is a tank guardian, so starting with the core ability, Rex's heavy attack inflicts a burn, dealing 10% damage per second for 10 seconds. So you can see on screen now the burn are being applied to your enemies. Now you've got to make sure that your enemies are not burn immune, otherwise Rex is going to be completely useless against them, because the burn is a main source to unlock his further utility. So if Rex's target is inflicted with a burn, each of Rex's basic attacks he lands has a 50% chance to grant him 1% armor. Now our biggest issue of this is 1% armor is not that great. Now it has a 50% chance as well, so it's not even guaranteed that every hit you do is going to be armor. Now during a fight you're going to be taking so much damage and you're just going to instantly lose that armor, so you're not really going to see it being applied to Rex at all. This is like whether you want to control Rex or not. I don't think he's going to be the best guardian where you just leave him to do his own thing, let the AI control him. I think he's one of those guardians where you kind of need to control at certain times in the fight just to keep him alive. Now moving on to his special ability, Rex fires a volley of toy missiles to each member of his team. Each missile grants 5% armor to all allies, and you can see that being applied on screen now, so your allies are going to be gaining that armor, so that is great. So enemies caught in the blast radius take 400% damage and are inflicted with a knockback. That's his special ability, very simple. All of your allies are going to gain some armor, and his special ability deals knockback, which is very important in Disney Mirrorverse. So moving on to the signature ability, which you get unlocked as a 4-star or above. Rex's special ability grants an additional 5% armor. Now I'm pretty sure this is to all your allies, so instead of 5% armor, they're gonna gain 10% armor. So Rex's special abilities inflicts a burn, dealing 10% damage per second for 10 seconds. So this is another source of burn. You can get it from the special ability and also by using a heavy attack. So Rex's special attacks have an additional 10% chance to grant him armor when striking an enemy inflicted with burn. So instead of a 50% chance, it will go up to 60%. Now it's still not guaranteed, and I like to see it guaranteed somewhere in his kit. So that is his signature ability, and that's basically Rex. So we're gonna move on to the talents now, starting with the first advanced talent. So Rex's fourth basic attack in the combo has a 77% chance to inflict his target with knockback. So another way to get knockback by just hitting your opponents, which is a key part. You want to keep hitting your opponents with that basic attack to gain the armor. And at the same time, on the fourth hit, you're going to have a 77% chance to inflict knockback. Now moving on to the second advanced talent, Rex resists 41% damage from any enemy inflicted with a burn. So him being a tank guardian, this is just going to make him a tank. So this is a really good talent to apply as well. Two solid advanced talents right there. And then moving on to the last advanced talent, if Rex has armor, his heavy attack does an additional 160% damage. So this is really good, because all you need to do is use your heavy attack to gain that burn. And then once you have the burn, you're going to be gaining armor. And then if you use a heavy attack again, it's just going to instantly do more damage. So it's just a really good way just to do more damage. You're going to need to be using those heavy attacks all the time. So you're going to gain armor, like a 60% chance, if you have above a 4-star. And then at the same time, you're going to be doing so much more damage every time you use that heavy attack. So moving on to the elite talent, if an enemy has a burn when Rex uses his special ability, he and his allies gain an indestructible buff that lasts for 2.3 seconds. Now the time on this can actually increase the higher you get this elite talent. So yeah, this is really good as well. It gives me Simba vibes a little bit, where he goes indestructible. So all your allies and also Rex become indestructible for a certain amount of time. It's a really good safety feature for Rex, and it's something you need to apply to him. This elite talent is very important. So we're going to go and move on to the traits. So he's tall, high tech, fiery, goofball, and Pixar. So he has amazing traits. So many good ones to use in towers and also rift raids. So what's my overall thoughts on Rex? Now, I think he's going to be a really solid tank guardian in the game. I don't think he's going to be top tier, but right now, just playing him, he seems solid, but he does have a little bit of a risk of dying when he first goes into the fight. So you might want to have another tank guardian who will just keep him alive until you get your first special ability, and you can be relying on that armor gain from the special ability. But overall, I think he's a solid tank in the game. Let me know what you think down below. We're gonna get into some gameplay now. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.